try to get back in the winning column. You know, I hate losing. Hated losing. You know, as you guys can tell, you know, I was kind of like a little bitch. But you know what? It just hurts, man. It just hurts being so close to something you always dreamed of, and then come up like short. When I thought I found a way to get to Klitschko, he adapted. He adapted real good, and I wasn't able to adapt to his adaptation. You know, so I wasn't able to keep up with him. Like every time he adapted, I was like, I kept getting lost. So that's the main thing. And whenever I started finding him, he adapted again. So that's the main thing. You know, it's the ring experience, it's the ring knowledge that, you know, he won this time, but it won't happen again.
Now, Chris, now that you kind of handicapped the fight, you were talking about some of the adjustments that Klitschko made. Now that you have, I don't know if you've seen the tape, but now that you think back on the fight, is there adjustments that maybe you should have made that might have made a difference in that fight?
Yeah, of course. You know, there's certain adjustments I should have done. I should have, you know, probably thrown more punches and asserted myself a little bit more. But regardless, man, I just couldn't get to him. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. You know, I just couldn't get to him, and he was just a better fighter that day. You know, that's why he's the best fighter in the world. And you know, my friend Kevin Johnson, you know, he gets his opportunity on December 12th, and you know, I wish him all the luck, and I believe he can pull it off. And if not, you know. You know, you got to tip your hand, head out to Vitaly Klitschko, because he's fighting all the fighters that people usually don't want to fight.
Now, Chris, let's go to December 5th. You've got Brian Minto coming up. What do you know about the guy? What should we expect from him? And how much have you seen of this guy?
Honestly, I haven't seen nothing. You know, I let Henry do everything, and I just take care. I just do what I have to do in the gym, just work out and with Henry and with Daryl in the mornings and. That's all I'm concerned about. But the main thing about it is you're going to see the same area you guys always seen, you know, an action-packed fighter that, you know, balls to the wall, you know. And you know what? I'm coming in there to win. There's no losing in me, ever.
Now, Chris, you're talking about earning this title shot. How did this loss change you? How did it change your outlook on boxing and maybe your desire to want to reach the top of that mountain?
You know, it does humble you, but it leaves a bitter taste in your mouth. You know, just being so close to something that you always dreamed of and not being able to get it, it just leaves a bitter taste in your mouth that you just want to take off. You know, you could fucking wash your mouth with scope and brush your teeth as much, but you're always going to have that taste in your mouth.
All right, now joined by Chris Ariola's trainer, Henry Ramirez. Henry, thanks for being with us. What are your thoughts on this upcoming fight?
Just looking forward to getting past the Klitschko fight, and there's no better way to get over a fight than to start preparing for another one, you know. Minto's a rugged guy, East Coast fighter, comes forward, puts pressure, you know, guy right in front of you. It should be a pretty entertaining fight.
And lastly, Henry, can this loss that he suffered to Klitschko, can he turn this into a positive for his career?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you know, the thing of it is we lost to the best heavyweight in the planet. You know, I mean, you know, we were 8-1 underdog. That obviously doesn't take the sting away from the loss. But, you know, we'll use that as a learning tool for myself and Chris. And, you know, I mean, one loss doesn't doom a career, you know. So I think, especially in the heavyweight division, you know, there's going to be plenty of opportunities for Chris. And, you know, with the backing of Gustin and now Heyman, I think, you know, he's going to be in some pretty big fights in the future.